Okay, so let us start the today's session. In the last session, okay, which was very first lecture of the course, okay. So in that, I'll explain you about what is expected from you after the completion of the course, okay. At the same time, I have briefed you about the content that we'll be covering throughout the course, okay. So as I told you in the last lecture, okay. So from this lecture onwards, okay, we'll be starting with the content, okay. So in the today's session, okay, we will start with first point, okay, and that is 1.1, and that is basic knowledge, okay, basic knowledge, okay. So with this, okay, we will start, okay. This is a first part of the first module, okay, that is related with the basic knowledge, okay. So see, okay, in order to start, okay, let me explain you, okay, what is heat engine, okay. Let us start with heat engine, okay, heat engine. Try to understand what is heat engine. Okay, so engine is basically the device which produces a power. Okay, engine is a device which produces a power. Okay, so what is the purpose of the engine? Is to produce a power. Now, how engine produces a power? Okay, so let us consider this engine E. Okay, this is the engine E. Okay, which receives, okay, some amount of heat. Okay, and it rejects some amount of heat. Okay, this is the engine which receives some amount of heat and it rejects some amount of heat, right? So obviously, as this is a heat engine, okay, it has to operate between two reservoirs, okay? Let us take first reservoirs as a T1, okay? Let us take another reservoirs as a T2, okay? So what this engine is doing, this engine is receiving Q1 amount of heat from the source, which is at a temperature T1, and it is rejecting Q2 amount of heat to the sink, which is at a temperature T2, okay? And while doing so, the engine is producing W amount into work, okay? So out of Q1, W it converts into work, okay? So how to calculate W? W is basically the difference between what is supplied and what is rejected, okay? So work done by the engine, it is a difference between heat supplied and heat rejected. So this is a power that is been produced by the engine, okay? All of you know that T1 is greater than T2, okay? Temperature T1 is greater than T2. So obviously the heat will flow from high temperature to low temperature. So when heat is flowing from high temperature to low temperature, what happens is power produces. So heat engine is a device which converts, okay? Heat engine is a device which converts, if you want, I'll just write down, it converts, okay, portion of heat into work. It converts portion of heat into work. Okay, so some portion of heat converts into work. Okay, only some portion of heat it converts into work. Okay, so this is a heat engine which converts some portion of heat receives into work. Okay, so see, whenever work is produced, okay, what we used to do, okay, we used to calculate efficiency. Okay, so what is the efficiency of engine? How we'll calculate the efficiency of engine? So efficiency of engine is given by, okay, output by input. Okay, so what output we got? Output we got in the form of work. Okay, output is a work, and input we have it in the form of heat. Okay, so in heat is the input, right? So work is the output, heat is the input, right? So if you ask me, okay, what is the formula for W now? What is W? It's the difference between heat supplied and heat rejected. So it's the difference of Q1 and Q2. Upon heat supplied is Q1, okay? Upon heat supplied is Q1. So what we get is equal to 1 minus Q2 by Q1, okay? So this is the formula for the efficiency of engine. It's an ordinary engine. This is an ordinary engine, right? What is the formula for efficiency of ordinary engine? It's 1 minus heat rejected by heat supplied, okay? Now, next case will be, okay, if you assume this engine to work on a Carnot cycle, if the engine is working on a Carnot cycle, then what is the formula for efficiency of Carnot engine? Okay, efficiency of Carnot engine is given by, okay, how to calculate the formula or efficiency of Carnot engine? It's directly 1 minus, okay, T mean by T maximum, okay, 1 minus, okay, T mean by T maximum, that is 1 minus T2 by T1, okay, this is a minimum temperature, this is a maximum temperature. So this will give me the efficiency of Carnot engine, that is 1 minus T2 by T1. Okay, is that okay? Yes, is that okay?
Yeah.
Okay, that means if if it is a Carnot engine, okay, if it is a Carnot engine, okay, so for Carnot engine, okay, what I done, I replace Q2 by Q1 by T2 by T1. You can see what I've done. I replace, okay, Q2 by Q1 as T2 by T1. See, in this formula, I replace Q2 by Q1 as T2 by T1. Then it becomes a Carnot engine. Right? Then it becomes a Carnot engine. So is that okay with the engine?
Sorry, ek baar repeat karo na.
See here, all of you. See, this is now, okay, we are starting with the 1.1, and that is a basic knowledge, okay, where we are going to initially see what is heat engine. So what is heat engine? Okay, heat engine is a device which converts, okay, portion of heat receives into work, okay. So this is an engine which is receiving Q1 amount of heat from the source, which is at a temperature T1, and it is rejecting Q2 amount of heat to the sink, which is at a temperature T2. So while doing so, engine converts Q1 minus Q2 into work. Okay, so see, this is the engine which receives the heat. Out of some heat receives, it converts some portion into work. Okay, so out of Q1, Q1 minus Q2, it converts into work. Then how much it rejects? It rejects Q2 amount of heat. Okay, so this is the engine. See, because what happens, naturally heat flow from higher temperature to low temperature. So heat, it is flowing from higher temperature T1 to lower temperature T2. Okay, so heat is flowing from higher temperature to lower temperature. Okay, and while doing so, okay, we are utilizing that heat, okay, in the engine. Okay, when heat flows from high temperature to lower temperature, we are using that heat so as to run an engine. So what the engine is doing? Okay, engine is receiving Q1 amount of heat. It is rejecting Q2 amount of heat by producing W is equal to Q1 minus Q2 amount of work, right? Now see, whenever the work is produced, okay, we'll be calculating efficiency of engine. How to calculate efficiency of engine? It's output by input. Output we got in the form of work. Input we have in the form of heat, okay? So output is a work, okay? Input is a heat, right? So work, how you get work, it's difference of Q1 and Q2, it is written upon, okay, heat input is Q1, so it's given by 1 minus Q2 by Q1. Okay, now see, if you assume this engine, okay, if you want this engine to work on a Carnot cycle, then what is the efficiency of Carnot engine? Then it is basically 1 minus T mean by T maximum, okay, and that we have seen in thermodynamics, it is 1 minus T mean by T max. So in this, okay, what is minimum temperature? It is T2. What is maximum temperature? It is T1. Okay, so it is T1. 1 minus T mean by T max. Okay, so what you observed in the formula of ordinary engine, okay, in the formula of ordinary engine, if you replace Q2 by Q1 as T2 by T1, it becomes a Carnot engine. You can see this is the formula of ordinary engine, 1 minus Q2 by Q1. This is the formula for efficiency of Carnot engine, that is 1 minus T2 by T1. That means we are replacing Q2 by Q1 by T2 by T1, then it becomes Carnot engine, right? Is that okay? Okay, what we are doing, we are replacing Q2 by Q1 by T2 by T1, so it becomes a Carnot engine. Okay, now see, this is what about heat engine. This is what about heat engine. Okay, now I'll be adding only one term.
So note karne ka kya?
No, I will share these notes. Okay. So see, this is heat engine. Okay. Now I will make this as a reversed heat engine. Try to understand. I'm adding one word. Okay. What is reverse heat engine? I'm just adding the word. Okay. That is reversed heat engine. Okay. Reversed heat engine. Okay. Now try to understand. What is reversed heat engine? Okay. So now see. Okay. Let us see this reservoir. Okay. Let us consider the reservoir. Same diagram I am drawing. This is T1. Okay, above reservoir is T1. Okay, below reservoir, okay, you can see, okay, this is T2. Okay, below reservoir is T2. Okay, now it is reversed. Okay, that means what? Heat should flow in a reverse direction. See, obviously, T1 is greater than T2. Okay, as like this. Okay, T1 is greater than T2. So now it's a reverse heat engine, right? So heat will flow from low temperature to high temperature. Okay, so for that, okay, we have a device that is called as reverse heat engine. Okay, you can see I've written the reversed E, okay, because in reverse heat engine, heat will flow from low temperature to high temperature. Okay, so this arrow is, this sign is also changed. It is reversed heat engine. Okay, so heat will flow now from low temperature to high temperature. You can see direction is changed. Now heat will flow from low temperature to high temperature. Right. Now see, heat naturally flows from high to low. Heat naturally flows from high to low. Okay. But if you want to operate in a reverse direction, okay, that is from low to high. Okay. So if you want to operate in a, okay, reverse direction, okay, some input is to be given. Okay. So if you want this reverse heat engine to abstract Q2 amount of heat, okay, if you want this reverse heat engine to abstract Q2 amount of heat, okay, W amount of work is to be supplied. Okay, W amount of work to be supplied. Until and unless you supply W amount of work, okay, Q2 will not be abstracted. Okay, so when you supply W, Q2 will be abstracted. As a result, Q1 will be rejected. Okay, so addition of W and Q2, okay, addition of W and Q2, you can see this Q2 and W, okay, it is rejected, and that we will call it as Q1. Okay, Q2 and W, you can see this Q2, this is W, okay, W plus Q2, and that is Q1, it is rejected, right? It is rejected. Okay, now see, when heat flows from, see, when heat flows naturally, heat flows naturally from high temperature to low temperature, in that case power produces, okay, in that case power produced. Okay, but when heat flows, okay, but when you want the heat to flow in a reverse direction, that is from low temperature to high temperature, power consumes. I repeat, when heat flows naturally from high to low, power gets produced. Okay, but if you want the heat to flow in a reverse direction, that is from low to high, okay, power gets consumed. That means you need to supply some power. Okay, so this reverse heat engine will abstract Q2 only and only when you supply W amount of work. Okay, so when you supply W amount of work, then it will abstract Q2 and it will deliver W plus Q2, that is Q1, to the, okay, reservoir, which is at a temperature T1. Is that okay? All of you, is that okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay, now see, all of you. Now see, this, whenever it's a heat engine, we have calculated efficiency. See, whenever power is produced, we are calculating efficiency. Okay, so power is produced in case of a heat engine. That's why we have calculated efficiency. Okay, now here, in case of a reverse heat engine, what happens? In case of a reverse heat engine, power gets consumed. You can say power gets consumed. Okay. So in such case, okay, we can't calculate efficiency. Okay. And in such case, okay, we need to calculate COP, that is called as coefficient of performance. Okay. That is called as coefficient of performance. And that coefficient of performance, okay, it is indicated by COP. Okay, coefficient of performance, it is indicated by COP. Okay, now what is coefficient of performance? It is okay, it is a ratio of, okay,
screen,
okay,
screen.
Desired effect. Yeah, I'll just make that screen. Okay, so it's a ratio of desired effect, okay, upon work input. It's a ratio of desired effect upon work input. Okay, COP is simply a ratio of what effect you want, okay, upon what in work input you require. Okay, so I'll just write down this as, okay, so COP is given by, okay, COP is given by desired effect. I will write down as it is, desired effect, okay, upon work input. You can see work input is double. Okay, work input is double. Now see, all of you, now here there is a major thing which you need to understand. Okay, now see this reverse heat engine, it can be either refrigerator or it can be heat pump. Okay, reverse heat engine. See, this is a diagram for the reverse heat engine. Okay, and further, reverse heat engine can be either, I'll just write down here, it can be either refrigerator, okay, it can be either refrigerator or or heat pump. Okay, diagram will remain same. Difference will be in terms of, okay, what effect we want. Okay, what effect we want. Okay, now let us start first with the refrigerator. Okay, let us start with the refrigerator. Okay, now I will start with, okay, I want to get now, okay, the COP of refrigerator. Okay, now I need to calculate COP of refrigerator. Okay, so in refrigerator, as you know, we want cooling, right? For refrigerator, we are interested in cooling. So desired effect will be cooling. Okay, upon work input is W, right? Upon work input is W, right? So COP of refrigerator is given by, see, now see, there are only two heats. One is Q2 and second is Q1. Okay, Q2, it is associated with the lowest temperature. Q1, it is associated with the higher temperature. You can see T1 is greater than T2. So this T1 is greater than T2, right? So the Q1, which is associated with the T1, it will be obviously at a higher temperature, right? So see, when you talk about Q2, it is associated with the lower temperature, okay? So obviously, out of Q1 and Q2, Q2 will give me cooling because Q2, it is associated with lower temperature. So I'll just write down this formula as Q2 by W, okay? Q2 by W, right? Because see, there are only two heats. One is Q2 and second is Q1. Q2, it is associated with lowest temperature. Q1 is associated with highest temperature. Okay. So Q2, which is associated with lowest temperature, it will give me cooling. Okay. So cooling effect will be given by Q2. Okay. So now I'll just write down this as, okay. So COP of refrigerator is given by, okay, Q2, I will write down as it is. Q2, I'll write down as it is. Now you can check W. What is the formula for W you can get? Okay, W, what is the formula for W? Q1 minus Q2. Okay, W is nothing but Q1 minus Q2. Okay, so COP of refrigerator is Q2 upon Q1 minus Q2. Okay, now see, when you assume this refrigerator to be Carnot refrigerator, when you assume this to be a Carnot refrigerator, what is the formula for COP of Carnot refrigerator you will get? Simply replace heat by temperature. Okay, so I'll just replace Q by temperature. So Q2, I will replace by T2. Q1, I will replace by T1. Q2, I will replace by T2. Okay. So I will get the formula for COP of Carnot refrigerator. See, if you assume this refrigerator to work on a Carnot cycle, if you assume this ordinary refrigerator to work on a Carnot cycle, okay, how to calculate efficiency? Simply, you replace heat by temperature. Okay. So that will give rise to the formula for Carnot efficiency. Okay. Carnot efficiency of refrigerator. Okay. Now let us go to the second case. Okay. Now let us go to the second case. The second case, okay, will be for the heat pump. Okay. Second case will be for the heat pump. Now I'll calculate, okay, COP of heat pump. Okay. How to calculate COP of heat pump? Okay. COP of heat pump. Now see, as I told you, Q2 will give you cooling. Okay. Q2 will give you cooling. Now for heat pump, we are interested in heating. Okay. Heat pump, the application is for heating. Okay. So for heat pump, okay, desired effect is heating. See, I am writing COP of heat pump. So for heat pump, what is the desired effect? It is heating. Okay. Upon work input is W. Upon work input is W. Okay. So COP of heat pump is given by, okay, heating. Now see, if Q2 is giving cooling, obviously Q1 will give heating, okay, because Q1 is associated with higher temperature. Okay, so I'll just write on this as Q1 by W. Okay, Q1 by W, right? So COP of heat pump is given by, okay, Q1 I have written as it is. Q1 I have written as it is upon W. What is the formula for W again? Q1 minus Q2. Okay, W is Q1 minus Q2, right? So what formula? What solution I get? COP of, okay, so COP of heat pump, it is Q1 upon Q1 minus Q2, right? Now see, if you assume this heat pump to work on a Carnot cycle, if this heat pump is again working on a Carnot cycle, then what is the efficiency of Carnot heat pump? Okay, what is the efficiency of Carnot heat pump? Simply replace heat by temperature. So it is T1 upon, okay, T1 minus T2.
Okay, it is T1 upon T1 minus T2. You can check it. Right? Is that okay?
Yes. Is that okay with this one? Yes. Can you repeat the question?
So your derivation is that?
Yeah. We are just analyzing the performance of the refrigerators and heat pumps.
So yeah, thermo
is that okay? Kar chuke hai na pehle. Yes.
Thermo.
Okay. So see, all of you, whenever it is a refrigerator, okay, we need to take lowest temperature upon highest temperature minus lowest temperature. Whenever it is heat pump, okay, we need to take highest temperature upon highest minus lowest temperature. See, this is very required, okay? Because further part, it is based on this derivation only. Okay. Now see, let us establish a relationship between, okay, the COP of
heat pump. Refrigerator rahega to lower le lega na?
Yes, refrigerator lower you take in the numerator. For heat pump, you take highest.
Higher.
In the numerator. Okay. Now see, now let us see here, all of you. Okay. Now see, all of you, so what is the formula for COP of heat pump? COP of heat pump. Okay, just here we have the formula Q1 by W, right? Q1 by W. This is the formula for COP of heat pump, right? So COP of heat pump is given by Q1. Okay, what is Q1 formula? W plus Q2. Okay. See, what is the COP of heat pump? Same I have written Q1 by W here, right? Q1 by W. Okay, now what is Q1? You can see W plus Q2. W plus Q2.
हेलो
सर, की आवाज नहीं आ रही है। सर का नेटवर्क गया है।
फोन आया था ना? फोन पे तो नहीं बात कर रहे सर, काम होगा बेचारे का रिजल्ट।
नो सी ऑल ऑफ यू, नाउ लेट अस सी, ओके, व्हाट इज द सीओपी ऑफ हीट पंप? इट इज क्यू1 बाय डब्ल्यू। सीओपी ऑफ हीट पंप इज क्यू1 बाय डब्ल्यू। ओके, so COP of heat pump is given by, what is Q1? Q1 is W plus Q2. Okay, W plus Q2 divided by W. Okay, so I'll just write down now the formula for COP of heat pump is equal to W by W is 1, right? Plus Q2 by W. Okay, plus Q2 by W. Okay, so you can see now what we'll get. So COP of heat pump is equal to 1 plus, okay, what is Q2 by W? You can check it. What is Q2 by W? Q2 by W is COP of refrigerator. It's a COP of refrigerator. Okay, so this is one more expression. Okay, which is very useful. Okay, COP of heat pump is 1 plus COP of refrigerator. Okay, so if COP of refrigerator is 4, okay, what is the COP of heat pump? It is 5. Okay, provided both are working within same temperatures. Okay, so if there is a heat pump, if there is a refrigerator, and if both are working within the same temperature limits, okay, and COP of, let's say, refrigerator is 1, then COP of heat pump becomes 2. Simple. We need to just add 1 into the COP of refrigerator. So it becomes this COP of heat pump. Is that okay? Is that okay? Yes. Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay. Yes. Now yes. Let us move to the next part. Okay. Okay. Now see, this is why this is required. Okay. Because we need to see these processes now in the detail. Okay. We need to see these processes in detail. Okay. Now let us see in the next, okay, point. Okay. What is called as Carnot cycle. Okay. Why I'm explaining this. Okay. Because we need to see after that reverse Carnot cycle. Okay, so for that, we should be able to recall what is Carnot cycle. Okay, so let us start with the Carnot cycle. Okay, I will simply draw the PV diagram, okay, for the Carnot cycle. Okay, so let us see this. Okay, this is a pressure scale. Okay, this is a volume scale. This is the PV diagram. Okay, at the same time, okay, we will also plot the TS diagram, because these two diagrams are very important. Okay, PV and TS. Okay, so let us plot the PV and TS diagram. Okay, for the Carnot. Okay, so how to plot those? Okay, you might have remembered this. Okay. So somewhat such diagrams you will get. Okay, I will just fastly go through it. Okay, let us see this point number one. Okay, this is point number two. This is point number three. Okay, this is point number four. Okay, point number 1, 2, 3, 4. Now try to understand. Okay, so this one, this is 1, 2, 2. Okay, this is 2, 2, 3. Okay, this is 3, 2, 4. Okay, 4, 2, 1 back. Okay, so it completes a cycle. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now what happens during 1, 2, 2? See, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 2, 4. Okay, they are same in nature. You can see 1, 2, 2 and 3, 2, 4. They are same in nature but different in direction. Okay, so when we talk about 1, 2, 2 and 3, 2, 4, okay, I will just mark their nature. Okay, so 1, 2, 2. I'll just show you it here only. Okay, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 2, 4. Okay, they are adiabatic, which is governed by law PV raised to 4 gamma is equal to C. Okay, what is the law for 1, 2, 2 and 3, 2, 4? They are adiabatic. Okay, so 1, 2, 2 and 3, 2, 4, they are adiabatic. That means the law is PV raised to 4 gamma is equal to C. See, they are adiabatic. Okay, what do you mean by adiabatic? Adiabatic is same as isentropic. Okay, that means 1, 2, 2 is isentropic process. See, adiabatic, it is nothing but isentropic. So 1, 2, 2 is a isentropic process. Okay, that means entropy at point number one is same as entropy at point number two. Okay, so if you observed entropy at any point on this line, it is same. That is S1 is equal to S2 because it is adiabatic process, and adiabatic, it is nothing but isentropic process, right? Now, what is about 3, 2, 4? 3, 2, 4, it is again adiabatic, and adiabatic is same as isentropic. Okay, so when you measure, okay.
Sir, 3, 2, 4 adiabatic, sir. Yes. Adiabatic means there is no exchange of heat, hai na?
Which one?
Adiabatic means no exchange of
heat. No exchange of heat. Yes, exactly. What is the meaning of adiabatic? Heat transfer is zero. That means no heat is received, no heat is rejected. Exactly. Yeah.
1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 3 is adiabatic.
No. 1, 2, 2 is adiabatic, and 3, 2, 4 is adiabatic. See where I have written the arrow. 3, 2, 4 is again the adiabatic. Okay. That means
how 1, 2, 2 or 3, 2, 4 is adiabatic.
I didn't get your question.
You are saying that 1, 2, 2 and 3, 2, 4 is adiabatic.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
So how it is adiabatic?
How it is adiabatic? See, we are seeing a Carnot cycle, right? We are seeing the Carnot cycle. So have you understand this Carnot cycle in the thermodynamics? Because Carnot cycle consists of four processes. Out of four processes, two are adiabatic and two are isothermal. Okay. So when you see this 1, 2, 2,
hello.
Okay. Yeah. 1, 2, 2 is adiabatic and 3, 2, 4 is also adiabatic. Okay. So we are compressing it by keeping entropy constant. Here we are expanding it by keeping entropy constant. Okay. That means we are carrying out those processes as a frictionless processes. Okay. So during 1, 2, 2, we will compress without any friction. During 3, 2, 4, we will expand without any friction. Yeah. Yes. Is that okay? Yes. Okay. So 1, 2, 2, it's isentropic or adiabatic compression. 3, 2, 4. It's isentropic or adiabatic expansion, right? Now let us see. So as I told you, during 1, 2, 2, entropy is constant, okay? During 3, 2, 4 is again, entropy is constant, okay? Now let us move to 2, 2, 3. So when you see 2, 2, 3, okay? So 2, 2, 3 is an isothermal process, okay? 2, 2, 3. So 2, 2, 3 and 4, 2, 1 is an isothermal process, right? So during 2, 2, 3, okay, isothermal process. So I'll just mention that law here. Okay, I'll just mention here. Okay, I'll indicate here. You can see this is 2 to 3. Okay, this is 4 to 1. See, this is 2 to 3, this is 4 to 1. It's a isothermal. Okay, that means law is PV is equal to C. See, 2 to 3, okay, and 4 to 1. Okay, these are the isothermal processes. 2 to 3 and 4 to 1, these are the isothermal processes. That means what is the law? PV is equal to C. Okay, now during 2 to 3, 2 to 3 is an isothermal process. That is, temperature is constant. Okay, that means, okay, temperature at point number 2 is same as temperature at point number 3. You can check. See, here I will take point number 2 now. Okay, temperature at point number 2 and temperature at point number 3, they are same, right? Similarly, 4 to 1 is again isothermal. So during 4 to 1, what happens? Again, temperature remains constant. That is, T1 is equal to T4. Okay. So along this line, okay, at any point on this line, again, temperature is constant. That's why T1 is equal to T4. Along this line, temperature is constant. So T2 is equal to T3. Okay. So this 1, 2, 2 and 3 to 4, they're adiabatic. Okay. That is constant entropy. 2 to 3 and 4 to 1, they're isothermal. Okay. That is, temperature is constant. Okay. Is that okay? Yes. Is that okay? Yes, let me know. Yes, let me know, all of you.
Repeat, so see, repeat, sir.
See, 1, 2, 2, it's an isentropic compression. So during 1, 2, 2, entropy is constant. During 1, 2, 2, entropy is constant. During 2, 2, 3, temperature is constant. Again, during 3, 2, 4, entropy is constant. During 4, 2, 1, adiabatic.
कौन सा है?
See, adiabatic is 1, 2, 2 and 3, 2, 4. 1, 2, 2 and 3, 2, 4, they are adiabatic. See, 1, 2, 2, you see, I just mentioned the arrow, huh? You can see this, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 2, 4, you can see the arrow. Okay. It's adiabatic. Yes. And this 2, 2, 3 and 4, 2, 1, they are isothermal. You can see on every process, okay. I mentioned the arrow, right? Now see, so from 1, 2, 2, we will compress it adiabatically. Okay, during 2 to 3, you can see, during 2 to 3, what we'll be doing is we are supplying the heat. Okay, so we will supply the heat by keeping temperature constant. During 2 to 3, we will supply the heat by keeping temperature constant. During 3 to 4, we will expand adiabatically. During 3 to 4, we will expand adiabatically. And during 4 to 1, okay, we will reject the heat, okay, by keeping temperature constant. We will reject the heat by keeping temperature constant. Okay. So our cycle, okay, if you look at, okay, this is our cycle. 1, okay, this is a cycle. 1, 2, okay, 2 to 3, okay, then 3 to 4, okay, and again 4 to 1 back. Okay. So this is our cycle. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 2, isentropic compression. 2, 2, 3, constant temperature heat addition. 3, 2, 4, isentropic expansion. 4, 2, 1, constant temperature heat rejection. Okay, so this we have plotted on a PV diagram. Now let us plot, okay, this process, okay, on a TS diagram. Okay, so let us start with process 1, 2, 2. So what the process 1, 2, 2 requires? 1, 2, 2 requires, okay, by keeping the entropy constant, we need to compress it. See, this arrow indicates it's a compression. Okay. But during compression, entropy has to remain constant. Okay. So if I take point number 1 here, okay, so entropy has to remain constant. That means I need to have a vertical line. Okay. On a vertical line only I need to move. Okay. Because from 1, 2, 2, entropy will remain constant. That is, point number 1 and 2 should lie on a same vertical line. Okay, because we are plotting on a TS diagram. Okay, so, but you can see here the fluid is compressed. Okay, so when the fluid is compressed, what happens is, okay, its temperature increases. Okay, so that is the reason why I am moving in an upward direction. Okay, so see, when I move from point number 1 to 2, okay, vertically on this line, what happens? Entropy is constant. S1 is equal to S2. On this line, entropy is constant, right? Now, why I'm going above, why I'm not going down? Okay, because we have compressed it. You can see the arrow is going upward. That is compressed. So whenever it is compressed, temperature will increase. Okay. So what happens during isentropic compression? During isentropic compression, entropy is constant, but temperature increases. Okay. Now let us go to the next process. 2, 2, 3. Okay. We need to supply the heat. During 2, 2, 3, we need to supply the heat. Okay, but how we will supply the heat? By keeping temperature constant. Okay, so during 2 to 3, what happens? Temperature remains constant and we'll be adding the heat. Okay, so if you want the temperature remain constant, okay, we need to move on a horizontal line. Okay, so we will move from point number 2, okay, to point number 3. Okay, so when we move from 2 to 3 on a horizontal line, what happens? During 2 to 3, you can see the temperature is constant. That is T2 is equal to T3. You can see T2 is equal to T3. The temperature is constant. Okay. But as the arrow is expansion, okay, you can see this is heat addition, right? This is a heat addition. Heat is supplied. So when heat is supplied, what happens? Entropy increases. Okay. That is the reason why I am going on a right hand side. See, from point number 2, I can go on a left hand side. That is all okay. Okay. But when I can go on a left hand side, when heat is rejected, okay, what is happening during 2 to 3? Heat is supplied. So I'm going on a right-hand side. So heat is supplied, right? Heat is supplied during 2 to 3. Okay, so by keeping the temperature constant, we are adding the heat. So as we are adding the heat, what happens with the entropy? It will increase. So that is the reason why I am moving on a right-hand side. Now let us go to 3 to 4. So 3 to 4, it is a reverse of 1 to 2. You can see. 3 to 4, it is a reverse of 1 to 2. 1 to 2 is a compression, 3 to 4 is a expansion. Okay. But both 1 to 2 and 3 to 4, they are done at constant entropy. Okay. So from point number 3, I will move downward till point number 4. Okay. Because I want the temperature at point number, entropy at point number 3 and entropy at point number 4 to be equal. So entropy point number 3 and entropy at point number 4, you can see they're equal. Okay. So during 3 to 4, entropy is constant. Okay. But during 3 to 4, what happens? There is expansion. You can see the arrow. That is expansion. That's why what happens? Temperature got decreased. So temperature got decreased from 3 to 4. Okay. See, here it was compression. So temperature was increased. Here it was expansion. So temperature was decreased. Okay. Now let us go to the 4 to 1. Again, 4 to 1, it is a reverse of 2 to 3. Okay. So I will move from 4 to 1 like this. Okay. So as you can see, what is 4 to 1? 4 to 1. Okay. By keeping the temperature constant. See, 4 to 1 is an isothermal process, right? Isothermal is nothing but what? Constant temperature. So by keeping the temperature constant, we are rejecting the heat. Okay. So during 4 to 1, what is happening? You can see the temperature is constant, right? Temperature is constant. Okay. But as we are rejecting the heat, what happens? Entropy got decreased. Entropy got decreased. Okay. So this is how we got the PV and TS diagram for the Carnot cycle. This is how we got PV and TS diagram for the Carnot cycle. Is that okay? Yes. Yes. Let me know. Is that okay? Yes. Is that okay with this one?
Yes, sir.
So this is all about the Carnot cycle. Okay. Now let us see. Okay. Reversed. Okay. I'm adding the one word. Reversed Carnot cycle. Try to understand. Reverse Carnot cycle. Okay. Okay. You just pay the attention. Okay. What is reversed Carnot cycle? What is reversed Carnot cycle? Okay. So for that, okay, let us understand this. Okay. I will plot the same diagram. Okay. This is P. A scale, this is V scale, PV. Okay, on the other hand, we have TS. Okay, this is PV, this is TS. Okay, let us plot the processes now. Okay, here on the diagram. Okay, so see what I'm doing in a reverse Carnot cycle. See what I'm doing in a reverse Carnot cycle. Okay, every arrow I'm changing, right? Every arrow I'm changing. You can say the direction of arrow I'm changing. See, this is going downward. Okay, you can check it. This is going downward. I will make it upward. This is going on a right. I will make it on left. Okay, this is going on upward, I will make it downward. See, this is going on a left hand side, I will make it on the right hand side. Okay, so this becomes reversed. Okay, see, obviously, see, when you change the direction of single arrow, na, rest of the arrow we need to change. I will change this, okay, like this. So when I change it like this, obviously this will go on the left, this will go down, this will go on the right hand side. Okay, now see, so now I will see, this is 1 2 2, right? What is the 1 2 2? 1 2 2 1 2 2. Okay, it's an isentropic compression. Okay, so I'll plot the point number one here. This is 1, this is 2. So this 1 2 2 is an isentropic compression. You can check, same process I've done. 1 2 2 1 2 2 is an isentropic compression. Okay, now what is 2 2 3? 2 2 3 is a heat supplied. 2 2 3 is a heat supplied. Now 2 2 3 is the heat rejected. You can check, this 2 2 3 is a heat rejected. See, this was a supplied. Okay, this was rejected. Okay, now what is 3 to 4? 3 to 4 was an expansion. Okay, so same we have. 3 to 4 is expansion. You can see this 3 to 4 is expansion, right? Okay, now what is about this 4 to 1? 4 to 1 is a heat rejection. Okay, now what is 4 to 1 here? 4 to 1 here, it's a heat supply. Okay, you can check it. 4 to 1 is a heat supply, right? See, you can see this 1 to 2 compression, 1 to 2 compression, right? Same we have. 1 to 2 is a compression, 1 to 2 is a compression. Same we have here. 2 to 3, it is heat supplied. 2 to 3 here is a heat rejected. Okay, heat is rejected. Okay, next 3 to 4, it is expansion. 3 to 4 is a expansion. Same we have, right? And what is 4 to 1? 4 to 1, it is a heat rejection. Here 4 to 1, we have it as a heat addition. Okay, so simply, okay, heat supplied we have replaced by heat rejected. Okay, heat rejected we have replaced by heat supplied. Okay, those changes we have made. Okay, so this cycle is turned out to be a reversed Carnot cycle. Okay, so let me show this process. Okay, 1 2 2 and 3 to 4. Okay, I'll just show it here only. This is 1 2 2 and this is 3 to 4. It's adiabatic. That is PV raised to power gamma is equal to C. You can see this 1 2 2 and 3 to 4, both are adiabatic. Okay, same like this 1 2 2 and 3 to 4, both are adiabatic. So law is PV raised to power gamma is equal to C. Okay, what is adiabatic? Okay, you can write down. Okay, S1 is equal to S2. Okay, that is adiabatic. Okay, adiabatic means what? Isentropic. Similarly, S3 is equal to S4. I'll just write down S3 is equal to S4. Okay, that is the meaning of adiabatic. That is, entropy is constant, right? Now what is 2 to 3? 2 to 3 same like isothermal. Okay, so this 2 to 3 and 4 to 1, they're isothermal. So here only I'll just mention that. You can see this 2 to 3 and this is 4 to 1. Okay, they are isothermal. So I'll just write on the law PV is equal to C. They're isothermal process. See, what is isothermal? Temperature is constant. Okay, that is T3 is equal to T2. Same, you can see T3 is equal to T2. That is isothermal. Okay. Similarly, this 4 to 1 is again isothermal, right? 4 to 1 is again isothermal. So T4 is equal to T1. T4 is equal to T1. You can check. Okay. So 1, 2, 2 is an isentropic compression. That is S1 is equal to S2. 2 to 3, during 2 to 3, it's an isothermal. I see, you can see this 2 to 3. On this line, temperature is constant. That is isothermal. Okay, so 2 to 3 is isothermal. Okay, but it's an isothermal. Okay, isothermal heat rejection. I'll just mention that. QR, it is heat rejection. Isothermal heat rejection. You can see 2 to 3 is isothermal heat rejection. What is 3 to 4? 3 to 4 is isentropic expansion. 3 to 4 is an isentropic expansion. Now, what is 4 to 1? 4 to 1, you can check. It's a, okay, isothermal heat addition. QS, isothermal heat addition. You can check it. See, whenever arrow was going on a downward side, it was supplied. So you can see arrow was going on a downward side, so it is supplied. Okay. When the arrow was going on the left hand side, it is rejected. You can check. When the arrow is going on the left hand side, it is rejected. Right. So this is what the cycle is. So I will just show it by dark. I will just now highlight the cycle. Okay. Okay. So as you can see, okay, so this is the PV diagram for the cycle. Okay, PV diagram for the Carnot cycle. Okay, now let us plot the TS diagram, same like that. Okay, so let us start. Okay, let us take point number one here. So this is point number one. Okay, so from point number one, okay, we need to compress it. But while compression, entropy has to be remains constant. That is, S1 is equal to S2. Okay, so I will move from point number one upward till point number two. Okay, so entropy is constant. You can say entropy is constant. That is, S1 is equal to S2. Okay, entropy is constant. S1 and S2, they are same, right? But as it is compression, obviously the temperature will increase. As it's a compression, temperature will increase, right? Now, next, 2, 2, 3. By keeping the temperature constant, we need to reject the heat. Okay, so we need to keep the temperature constant. Okay, that means it should be a horizontal line. It should be a horizontal line, and we need to reject the heat, so entropy will decrease. Okay, so on the horizontal line, what happens? The entropy decreases, so we'll get point number three here, right? So this horizontal line indicates it's a constant temperature process, and this arrow indicates, okay, it's a heat rejection, because during heat rejection, what happens? Entropy decreases. So entropy got decreased. You can see entropy is decreased during heat rejection. Okay. Now let us go to the next process. Let us go to the now next process, 3, 2, 4. So 3, 2, 4, it is a reversed of 1, 2, 2. See, 1, 2, 2 is going above, 3, 2, 4 is going downward. Okay. So 3, 2, 4, it's a reverse of 1, 2, 2. So simply I will plot it here like this. What is 3, 2, 4? 3, 2, 4 is an isentropic expansion. So during 3, 2, 4, entropy is constant. That is, S3 is equal to S4. S3 is equal to S4. And as it is expansion, you can say the arrow is going downward. That means it is expansion. So during expansion, what happens? Temperature drops down. Temperature decreases. So during 3 to 4, temperature decreases, right? Temperature decreases during 3 to 4. Okay. Because see, 3 to 4 is isentropic. That is, S3 is equal to S4. Okay. But it is the expansion also. So temperature will decrease. So 1, 2, 2 and 3 to 4, they are exactly reversed. Okay. Now let us go to 4 to 1. So 4 to 1, it is a reverse of 2 to 3. Okay. So I will move from 4 to 1. Okay. Like this, it is reverse of 2 to 3. Okay. So what is 4 to 1? By keeping the temperature constant, we need to add the heat. Okay. So during 4 to 1, it's a horizontal line. Okay. That is, temperature is constant and we are adding the heat. As a result, what happens? The entropy will increase. So entropy will increase from S1 to S4 to S1. Okay, entropy will increase. So this is all about the, okay, the reverse Carnot cycle. Okay, try to understand simply. Okay, the supplied I replace by rejected. See, here it was, here 2 to 3 was supplied, here 2 to 3 is rejected. Okay, here 4 to 1 was rejected. Okay, here 4 to 1 was supplied. Okay, these are the only two changes, okay, which we have made. So this cycle is turned out to be reversed Carnot cycle. Okay, is that okay?
Yes, sir.
You understood the cycle? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what we'll do, okay? Today we will conclude with this, okay, what is taken today, okay? And in the next lecture, okay, we will see, okay, how to calculate the COP of reverse Carnot cycle. Okay, in the next lecture, okay, we will see how to calculate the COP of reversed Carnot cycle, okay, or reversed Carnot, reversed refrigerator, okay, or reversed heat pump, okay. So okay, that those sir. Things we will see in the next lecture. Yeah. Is that okay with this one?
Thank you.
Okay. Yes. What we have done is done today. Okay. Initially, okay, we have seen. Okay, initially we have seen the heat engine. See, what we have done today, we have started with the, you can see, we started with the heat engine, okay, followed by, we have seen the reversed heat engine, and followed by, we have seen Carnot cycle and reversed Carnot cycle. Okay, we have seen Carnot cycle and reversed Carnot cycle. So, in the next lecture, we will calculate the efficiencies of these cycles. Okay, so in the next lecture we will calculate the efficiencies of this cycle. Is that okay?
Yeah.
सेमेस्टर का रिजल्ट कब आएगा?